from a dispatch standpoint, we got a shots fired call at 18th and Wood. Actually, what was going on, our narcotics unit, as well as our tactical unit, our SOU, we were following up on an investigation from a few days in the past involving a fentanyl deal. We responded to 18th and Wood to attempt to do another undercover operation to buy more fentanyl. At that point, when the deal didn't go through, at that point we already had information on the individuals that we had bought previous from. So at that point, we went to effect an arrest, and at that point, there was gunfire from the suspects of the vehicle as well as the officers.
Gotcha. So it started as a several days long investigation into fentanyl and drug use. When that was tried to happen today, something went wrong when the arrest tried to happen, and who fired at who?
At this point, we're not sure, but in those situations, you got individuals in a car that's heavily armed, that's dealing drugs, and as the officers attempted to effect an arrest, that's when the shots were fired.
Now, is it only three officers that were hit?
Yes, three officers were hit. They're all in stable condition, non-life-threatening injuries.
Was there an informant or anyone else injured?
No one else injured at this point other than the suspects. There were three to four individuals that were also shot by gunfire from the officers.
Are they all the people that you were looking for today? Or are these people not associated with this?
No, they are associated with the investigation.
Any update on how they're doing?
They're in stable condition, non-life-threatening.
Chief, one of the things that Nancy was mentioning is today there was, a promotion for some new officers. I mean, just how tough is that when you have a situation where you're promoting new officers and then something like this happens so quickly after?
Yeah, you know, and sometimes you just don't realize the ups and downs of policing. I was, you know, just, you know, this happened at 3:17. At 2 o'clock, I was doing a promotional ceremony, promoting six very deserving officers. Their family was there celebrating. And now I'm talking about three officers that were just shot, you know, and as a leader of an organization, that's the one thing that keeps me up at night, how, you know, I'm putting young men and women at risk every night to protect the citizens of Kansas City, Kansas. And, you know, that's one of those things that really keeps you up at night.
I suppose this is another anecdote on how dangerous the fentanyl trade is in this city and in the regions around it. This is a pretty good example of that.
Most definitely. And we've identified that early in KCK, going back to December of 21, January, where we put in a lot of violent crime initiatives with a detailed response to fentanyl. And what we're seeing is fentanyl is now, as we remember in the early 90s with the crack cocaine epidemic, these are the same. Now you have these crack dealers that are now selling fentanyl. So the violence, the guns, just about every fentanyl search warrant that we get anywhere from 2 to 5 guns through those search warrants. So yeah, it's causing a lot of overdoses, but there's a lot of violence attached to it. And we're really, and this is another example of how we're going after it day to day.
And you may have already spoken to them, but what would you want to say to those officers who might be listening in?
Well, we're here to support you. Your community's here to support you. Anything you need, we will give for you. And we just appreciate how you put your life on the line to protect us and allow us to do the things that we sometimes take for granted.
Chief, is anyone being actively sought? Anyone else being sought?
At this point, we believe we have everyone who was involved in the shooting.
Chief, what do you want to say to the community that you guys are out here tackling this issue with the fentanyl in this community?
Yeah. If you look, one thing, we had a big peace walk on Saturday, and you know, we really explained we have our crime is significantly down, and one of those are contributing to the way that we're really attacking the fentanyl. And like I said, we're not using users as suspects, we're using them as witnesses so we can get to the individuals that are selling, that are dealing, that are associated with the violence.
For people just now tuning into our newscast as we're carrying this live, do you mind going over the facts again of this being an undercover investigation?
Yeah, we had previously conducted an undercover fentanyl buy. We responded today to try to buy additional fentanyl pills, at which time the deal didn't go through. So at that point, we were going to execute an arrest. During the execution of the arrest, individuals in the car got into a gun battle with the police officers.
Were both parties in the cars, their cars at the time?
Yes, we believe all individuals, the suspects, were all in their cars at the same time as our SOU, our tactical officers, responded to place the individuals under arrest.
Gotcha. So a marked car came in and...
Yes, a marked car as well as one of our undercover vehicles.
Gotcha.
So, yes.
Were the officers who were shot working in the undercover capacity?
No, they were working in our tactical unit in tactical gear.
Can you tell us how long this investigation's been going on, the fentanyl?
Well, I can't really go into details, but it's a long-reaching investigation. The drug buy occurred a couple of days ago on our end with our narcotics unit. So from the narcotics standpoint, this particular investigation started a couple of days ago.
What's the influx of fentanyl now? I mean, are we talking large?
Yeah, it's large amounts. I mean, we were set there today. We bought a large amount a couple days ago, and we were there to buy another large amount. So, like I said, there is violence, extreme violence, associated with these individuals that are selling this stuff.
The amount that was purchased last time, and maybe the amount that you're purchasing this time, how long would that supply last this city? I mean, how impactful is that?
Well, when you talk about that one pill can kill if it's not mixed correctly, and, you know, when you talk about buying several thousand pills, that's several thousand lives that you can potentially save from overdosing.
Chief, so are we saying that the targets of this investigation are higher-level suppliers of fentanyl thought to be?
Well, we don't know. That's something that the investigation, but I can tell you that who we target is the dealers. So, and we try to go even further up, but I know in this particular case, we were targeting the dealers. The investigation hadn't reached the level to the suppliers.
Chief, what would your message be to these folks that are trying to bring fentanyl into the community? What would you want to say to them about, you know, how you guys are serving and the work that you're doing?
Yeah, that we're working with the community to, first of all, stop the flow of illegal fentanyl, and the second part is really aggressively going after those who are dealing it to reduce the violence in KCK.